Hi, welcome to Mr. Techpathy Tutorials. This is part 1 of Linux device drivers. Let's start with the scope of this tutorial. Main scope of this tutorial is to help you gain in-depth knowledge on Linux device drivers. From now on, for your convenience, we will be discussing this topic part by part. Coming to prerequisites, one should have familiarity with Linux kernel basics. Without Linux kernel basics, it's a bit difficult to program Linux device drivers. So, I strongly recommend everyone to brush up your Linux kernel basics before proceeding further. Next, we'll list out the terminologies we use throughout this tutorial. When I say user, assume I'm referring to applications. When I say driver, assume I'm referring to Linux device drivers. Today in this part 1, we'll know what is a Linux device driver. So, what's a Linux device driver? Linux device drivers are distinct black boxes that make a particular piece of hardware respond to a well-defined internal programming interface. They completely hide the details of how the device works. Figure here will give you the exact picture about device driver definition. When user application wants to access hardware information, it accesses through Linux device drivers. One may ask, what is the need of Linux device driver? Why can't the user application access hardware directly? Allowing a user application to directly access hardware is very dangerous and not secure. So, Linux kernel restricts the user space applications to directly access the functionality of a particular hardware. Only one secure way for a user applications to access hardware information is by using Linux device drivers. Linux device drivers provide a programming interface which helps the user applications to access particular functionality of hardware without knowing the hardware details. Note that the programming interface here should be built separately from the rest of the kernel and plugged in as a module at runtime when needed. In this way, device drivers provide more security and flexibility. Points to note while writing a driver, device driver. While writing a driver to a specific device, remember that each driver is different. As a driver writer, you need to understand your specific device well. You need to gather all information like data sheets, design documents, and schematics of your device from device vendor. Please note that it is very difficult to teach about specific device in this tutorial. Instead, we'll teach you how to build the background required to make your device work. What's the role of device driver? As stated earlier, user activities are performed by means of a set of standardized calls that are independent of specific driver. Mapping those calls to a specific operations that act on real hardware is then the role of device driver. What does this mean? When a user application needs particular information of hardware, it uses system calls provided by Linux device driver to access the information. The way in which this system call mappings are done to the device specific operations that act on real hardware is the role of device driver. Hope you are clear on what a Linux device driver is and its role. That's it for today. I recommend you to watch this tutorial multiple times without missing any point. That will help you to follow upcoming tutorials without any issues. We'll continue our next topic in Linux Device Driver Part 2. Till then, stay tuned. Please feel free to comment and query. Don't forget to subscribe Mr. Techpathy videos in YouTube. Thanks for watching. Goodbye for now.